Hello, today I'm going to talk about the project level parameters which can be used to give the information about the project on schematic and on your PCB. For example, here as you can see that in this schematic, I didn't update any kind of parameters just to show you how you can update all these parameters at the project level. Yeah, so that is the topic today, and about that I will give you the detailed information how you can define all these parameters. And for example, if you have more than one schematic sheet in your project, then it's valid for all the sheets. You have to just define only one time and it will come automatically for in all the sheets. So to define these parameters at the project level, why I'm saying it as a at the project level, which means that these parameters will be shown in the schematic and in the PCB. For example, if in your case, if you have more than one PCB, different kind of variants and so on, so in that case this parameter definition is valid for all the schematics and across all the schematics and all the PCBs. But important thing is that your PCBs, all the PCBs and your all the schematics should be under one project. If they are not under one project, then this parameter is parameter definition is not valid for all the schematics and PC. So just keep in that mind. So for that, what you have to do, you have to go to the project options, and in options you have to go here in, there are different tabs, and here this tab which is called parameters. So here parameter, so what you have to do, you have to add the parameter. So this parameters are, for example, let's say the first parameter project name, and provide the value to this project name, or I can say so pass the value for parameter, and say in my case it's a series voltage regulator, series voltage regulator, say okay, and you will say okay here. So here you can see that that name came. Why? Because in this project section I said this value will be equal to the project name, and this project name, as I said, that I define it here. So that's why, and that's how you can define the rest of the parameters. For example, here ENG approval date. So let's define this parameter here in parameter section of at the project level. So let me copy this. Either you can copy this ENG engineering approval date, or for example you can also write here, let's say if you don't want to use this one and you have your own, then that's what you can also write here. You can say okay, this will be equal to, let's say only I will write it complete, like engineering approval date. So that's how I think it's just taking only the valid name from here, and this one is still now not added in the by default. It has added some parameter by default in the project options parameter, and here it's not added this. So what you have to do, you have to copy this and you have to go here, project options, in parameter you have to add this parameter and pass the date of today, so it's 2022 10 07 parameter here. I hope that it has updated the date. So here you can see that it has already updated, which means that you don't need to use the default parameter what is defined here. You can also define the parameters what is convenient for you. So let me update all these parameters and then we will see how it looks like. So this is the second parameter. So let me copy this. I think it's a design approval date. Let me update here design approval date. Say we will give the date from today, say okay, and then I hope so. That's how. Then check approval date, and then let me define this parameter also here in the project options and in this parameter section. And so let's give the approval date 1 week before, so all the dates are not same here. So as you can see that, then BOM, for this BOM number DOC document, number boom. So let define this parameter here in project options and say this number is let's say boom 1 2 3 4 5 6, and this is the number for the boom. So that number came, then assembly drawing number. So let's copy this. Instead of doc, you can also write doc number assembly drawing. So you can also write, as I said previously, that you can also write your number. So I say drawing number 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and say okay, and so it's here available. So that's how you can update all these parameters here in this section, and it's very easy and convenient to use. For example, here instead of this title, I can choose here the title, let's say the name of the project, or let's say project name, let's say the name of the project. So here you can see that as soon as you choose here by title this text, it come automatically. Yeah, that's how you can change the number. For example, if you have at the side here, if you have any kind of number, or if you wanted to provide this number and this number is same, that's why this assembly drawing number came at the top. And for example, if you wanted to provide this number, then just copy this and also add here in the project option parameter and say this is 145 147 85 2 3 6 9. I'm just typing the random number, so don't get confused. So as soon as you type this number, so you can see that this number is available here. So that's how you can update all the numbers, all the parameters in at the schematic level. And for the PCB at a level, what you can do here, if you will see that, then you have seen that this text is in the schematic, this text is equal to the name of the parameter. And what you have to do here in the PCB, the, for example, if you have write here the name of the project, date and variant that you need, for example, to supply your supplier for the PCB manufacturer, that he will get the information regarding, for example, if you have more than one PCB. So in that case, you can also provide here the information. So let me place here, for example, one text. So let me take here this string, place this string and say here project name, and so that you can change. So you can define where you have to put this, not on the top layer. Normally I put it on top overlay, and then I have to go to the so let's go to the top overlay. You can put on the assembly layer. So and this the extension to call the project is like this. You have to just copy this and paste here, and let me take the also, for example, here the second, right here, let's say date, and then here. So this name of the project, how can you extend? Again, you can go here in project options, and you have to see here what is the how you have written this project name. So it's just the project name. So what you have to do, you have to, in PCB, you can call with this tracks with point at the first, and then the name of the, here OJEC, so project name, like that. So it will automatically take the name what you have provided in the name of the project in the project option parameter. So as soon as you say you can see that it has taken that name, which is called series voltage regulator, like that. For example, if you wanted to call the date, then you can call this date by putting here point extension, and then the date will come here. As you see that we don't have the date here in project options and a parameter. So I will say current, I will say okay, new parameter, just only date, and date from today 2022 10 and let's say 07. So as soon as you put, I hope that it will come automatically here in the PCB. So that's how you can write the parameter on in PCB, and as well as in schematic. Yeah, and not only at the top overlay, on the layer, wherever you want. If you have a mechanical layer, you can also write over there. Not only the project parameter, you can also define here the parameters which are which are important from for you from design point of view and from the PCB manufacturer point of view. Yeah, so that's how you can pass the parameter in schematic and PCB. Yeah, so thank you very much. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel. I appreciate that. Thank you.